Brittany.
What up, I'm Austin.
And we're here in the beautiful island of Fahimi.
Fiji.
Fiji. Yep. Fahimi, Fiji.
Literally where Fiji water is made.
They actually make Fiji water in Fiji?
Yeah.
Where do they make Fiji water? Why is it called Fiji water
then? Like in Nebraska or something.
Alright, so we're gonna play a little game.
But who's most likely to?
Who's more likely to?
More likely to.
I'm not playing with you anymore. Alright. Okay, this first one's like easy. Who's messier?
You, big
That's
time.
Definitely,
like,
definitely
look at
me.
Your freaking, like, your socks right now.
Okay, we're in sand. I first washed them, worn them in sand anyway, but.
Who is more patient? Not me.
I'm definitely way more patient.
I'm more patient with
Wait, let me think about this.
Have you thought of an answer yet?
I'm thinking.
Come on.
Austin. Be patient.
No.
Okay, it's definitely me. I'm definitely way more patient.
I'm patient with some things.
Money. Patient with money?
Saving
no, you're not. Because you
saving
wanna,
money.
No,
money.
No, that doesn't make any sense. Because you like you are not patient. You're not patient making money. You like whenever you go into work, you're like expecting to make like $15 an hour.
Well, that's not a bad thing.
No.
To want more money. Like,
no, but you're not patient with it.
To be motivated.
You are not patient with it. You want it now.
Yeah. Well, that's
actually
true.
Actually kind of like I'm like very like impulsive. Like I'm such an impulsive buyer.
Yeah.
So that's kind of we're getting way off. This has nothing to do with patience. Next question. Who is more likely to be on a reality TV show?
You'd be the Bachelorette.
You were talking about how you wanted to be on The Bachelor, though.
That'd be
and
cool.
And I can see you as a contestant.
That'd be cool. I'd have all those girls.
But okay, so like whenever you first meet her, you have to like, you get out of the limo and you have to say something to impress her, to like make yourself stick out. What would you say to The Bachelorette? What would you say to me if I was The Bachelorette to impress me? Bring me some buffalo wings.
I might. I probably don't have to say
Dress
anything.
Dress up like a buffalo wing. Ride up on a buffalo.
That's name is
and
Wing.
Eat Wing. Oh my
His
God.
Name is Wing.
Okay,
if I ever had an exotic pet, it would be a buffalo.
If I'm ever on The Bachelorette, if I'm ever The Bachelorette, boys will come to impress me.
Buffalo. Good luck in that.
Do you know buffalo wings are not named buffalo because they have anything to do with buffalo wings?
It started in Buffalo, New York.
Oh, you didn't even let me. I was going to tell
you. I've looked this up. I've been curious.
That was my fun fact.
All right, next question.
Next question.
Who is more likely to go broke?
Me.
That's not a good
Actually,
one.
Actually, you make a lot of big purchases. I make little tiny purchases like McFlurries
Before?
And like buffalo
no,
wings.
No.
And fuzzy socks.
No,
like
are you
$4
kidding?
$4 purchases.
Before my computer,
oh,
which
thanks.
Was almost a $300 purchase, an entire computer setup. Before that, the biggest thing I bought since then was my GoPro.
Yeah, how much is that?
$300.
That's what I'm talking about.
2 years.
You just proved my point.
2 years in between, though.
Still.
2 years of saving money.
You buy more expensive
You
things.
Save money more on like an hourly basis.
I make more money on an hourly basis. Yeah.
Pairs of sweatpants, two are navy, two are gray. So a lot of days it looks like I'm wearing the exact same sweatpants over and over.
I'm just kidding. You have better style than me probably. I feel like you definitely like take care of yourself more. I kind of just
I
go days without brushing my hair. And
I feel like it's
days
just,
without
okay well it's just really easy for me to brush my hair because I was smarter I guess. But I feel like it's a lot easier for girls to be more, like, stylish than guys.
I feel
that's
like
so true.
We do
You'll have,
like,
a
bigger
a whole
variety.
Lot, bigger...
We can wear skirts, we can wear dresses,
that's what I was
we
thinking.
Can wear shorts, we can wear pants, we can just go commando, we can go full-on
the
nude.
Pants suit.
That's true.
Alright, next question. Next question. Who is more likely to get arrested?
Honestly, we probably get arrested. Together doing some
actually that probably
dumbass
would be true.
Stuff
probably like at like a party or something.
No, I feel like it'd be something really dumb. Like we'd be like driving around and like you'd like steal my McFlurry and I'd swerve off the road and the cops would like pull us over and be like, "Man, have you been drinking tonight?"
I was
and
thinking
then,
like freaking, like, failure to turn signal or something like that, and they pull us over, and someone, like, cops an attitude.
No, I feel like in an inquiry situation, it's way more likely. My aunt was on a reality TV show for cops. Did I ever tell you about that?
Yeah.
Yeah, so, okay, my little cousin, Trey, was, like, in the back seat. He was crying because he didn't have this monkey. So my aunt, he was, like, one at a time. My aunt had this monkey, and she was, like, making him laugh and stuff, and she was, like, swerving all over the place. And so this cop just saw this lady, like, laughing and, like, talking to this monkey and swerving.
What?
And they thought she was on drugs, so they brought her to the hospital. I can literally call her right now and, like, have her give you the story.
I believe you.
I swear. If she wasn't going to be on cops, but she was like, no, sir, you are not, because she's, like, a psychiatrist. She was like, you are not, like, putting my name out there as a druggie on an episode of Cops.
Would she get paid for it?
Yeah. Every time it played.
Every time it played, how much?
I don't know. Next question is, who's more likely to get fat? Oh, well, I left my McFlurry over there, so hold on, let me go grab it while we finish this video.
All right.
Who's more likely to be on a TV game show? Well, okay, one thing, like the number one thing on my bucket list is to be on Family Feud. So.
What's his name? Steve Harvey? I don't like Steve Harvey. I feel like he forces, like, every reaction he has to do. And it's really, like, hard and cringy to watch.
It's
funny. I mean, literally, his jokes are all the same. Like, some woman says something like,
I don't want to talk about this anymore. You're making me upset because this is my dream. You're, like, shitting on my dream right now. Why don't you be the host?
It's called reality. Reality is shitting on your dreams.
Why don't you be the host then?
Because I couldn't do it. I can't do the same face every single day.
It's easy.
Yes, it literally. Though. It's always just like some woman will say something sexual, and he literally will just look at
sexual.
Her.
Sexual. I've never heard any sexual comments on Family Feud. Are we talking about the same show right now?
Yes.
Family Feud.
It'd be something like.
Family Feud. It's family oriented. They are not making any sexual jokes on there.
They make some very, very hardcore sexual innuendos.
No. Give me one example.
I'm going to put a clip in here right now of one. There's something with an old woman. I know there is one for sure. I'm going to find it on YouTube. I'm going to put it in here.
Right. Let's go to the clip.
100 men, name a part of your body that's bigger than it was when you were 16.
Your penis.
And we're back.
And we're back.
And I was right, huh? Oh, fuck.
Is it still going?
Yeah, it's still going. Next question. Who is most likely to be rich? Sounds a little narcissistic, but I'd say me. Actually, I don't know. I feel like you're going to have, like, some, like, stroke of luck with something.
I'm super
later.
Lucky.
Like, if you do journalism.
Like,
No, I mean, like, whatever you're doing, like, whatever your job is, like, journalism, I bet, watch, you're going to make some story that's going to, like, break headlines across the world or something. Like.
Or you know what's going to happen? I'm going to be, like, reporting on a story, and I'm going to get shot or something, because my little stupid self's going to put myself in a bad situation.
No, the Britt Fossa with the news in the hood.
No, Egg McBriddle.
Egg McBriddle with news in the hood.
What if, like, my very first job was, like, like a spokesperson for McDonald's or something, or like a McDonald's reporter, and I'd be like, Egg McBriddle here.
I bet you if you got famous or something, and you like had your nickname as Egg McBriddle, McDonald's would sign you to like some
sponsorship. Yeah, they would. You would. You hear that, McDonald's?
I would see a commercial with you standing right behind the counter, being like, would you want an Egg McBriddle with that?
As long as I get free McFlurries. Next question. Who is more likely to forget something important? Hey, didn't you have a test due, like, at 5 o'clock? What time is it? 5:30?
I had a test at 9:30 this morning and didn't know about it until probably 9:30, 12 hours before. 9:30 p.m. the day before.
I'm trying to think of if ever... I forgot about graduation. I forgot that day.
How did that work out?
And I went out the night before.
One time I forgot... my brother, I was supposed to pick him up. I was in high school and he was like in grade school or something. So I think I was out for summer already and he was still taking his exams. And I remember my mom specifically said, like, hey, I'm not gonna be home tomorrow. Like, why don't you go get your little brother from school? So set an alarm. And I was like, okay. I swear to God, sometimes I'll set an alarm and literally when I wake up, it just didn't go off. Like, I'm literally not kidding. That's not an excuse either. Like, sometimes I'll look at my phone and I'll be like, oh yeah, just forgot.
Yeah.
And I'll look back too and see like, oh, I set it for AM, not PM. But I woke up actually to my mom blowing my phone up, just yelling my ass off, like ooh, chewing
mama
me out.
Drama.
Yeah, chewing me out. I got so much trouble with that.
This has nothing to do with forgetting anything, but I just remind you of a funny story. So my friend told me sophomore year, we were in the car with a grandma, and she was like, in my high school, they had these huge speed bumps, like, probably the size of, like, a body. Like, it felt like you were running over someone. I'm sorry, that was really explicit. Well, we were, like, on our way to volleyball practice one day in the summer, and she was like, watch out, grandma, there's a speed bump coming up there. And she thought that she was like, watch out, grandma, you need to speed up there. So she zooms it. We fly over. We fly over the speed bump. Her grandma was like, oh, my goodness.
Go get air?
Yeah, we got there.
Sick air?
Oh, so you said, did we get there? Yeah, we caught her.
Sick. All right. Who is nicer/meaner?
I'm definitely way nicer than you are. Yeah. Watch, go ahead, insult me. I know it's coming. I'll let you insult me on.
You look like a butt.
Oh. You know what? Shut up.
Breaking news, it's Brittany's little sister's birthday.
She's 17. My girl's growing up. Get this girl on speakerphone.
You're going to say something she's not supposed
to
do.
I'm not going
to
answer.
Kidding.
What if she was like Brittany over here yesterday? And I was like,
The way my family's birthdays work out is that brother was born on February 1st. I was born on June 2nd. My mom was born on December 3rd. And my dad was born on December 28th. So
whoa,
it kind of just throws it off.
My sister, me and my family all have birthdays on holidays. My birthday is on Memorial Day. Kelly's birthday is on President's Day. Or is it? It's either President. George Washington's birthday, I believe, is today. I believe. George Washington was born on this day.
Oh,
dude, that's common knowledge. Didn't you do this? And I'm kidding.
I forgot my George Washington pocketbook back inside. Can I go get it?
Final question of the day, ladies and gentlemen. I must start with the gold one. Go ahead. You can do the honors.
What is your favorite meme?
My favorite meme right now, at the moment, I mean, it changes, like, probably, like, every few days. Like, it's definitely the Bork Bork meme. That's, like, it's when you're frightened. You know what I'm talking about? But I have a Pinterest board dedicated to them. These are all Bork Bork memes. Be that, Saka! How dedicated
boring.
Are you?
I'm just gonna go with a good old classic, a summertime favorite, Caveman SpongeBob.
That's a good one.
Those are by far the funniest. Every time like I saw one of those, I thought they were really funny. So, I didn't mind listening to that. What in tarnation?
What in tarnation? So, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for watching.
We're talking, blah, 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 we're having a conversation, and let's check the audio.